Praise the Lord, global Christian friends. This is Bishop Young, and how glad and how happy and how thrilled we are to give you a absolute understanding about these things taking place without going into the background. And there's a whole lot of knowledge in the background that we can give you about these things, but we won't do these things today, going into the background of how all these things came about in the first place. These things that are taking place here are in this great book of Revelation, and making an image to the beast. Remember back in the old days, in the book of Daniel, there was an image that was made as well too. So we see these things are copycats, and you understand the way that we understand that these things are emulants. They emulate things that has been done. They are not creators. God is the creator, but they are emulators, and they emulate the things that are done. They are false preachers, they are false teachers, they are false Christ. The Bible speaks of false apostles, and they are out there across the world and across time. But making the image to the beast. Now, I want to look at verse 15. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast that they are to make. Think about that statement. He's got the power to give life unto the image of the beast that he told them to make an image of. Now, I want to make a distinction between biological life and zoological life. Biological life is a life that everything in life and creation does and exists and live by those principles. Zoological life is the life of the soul and the spirit. So it's not the zoological life that he's calling the image to live, but it biological life. And, you know, there's cloning. Praise God. There are all kinds of ways you could make things live and exist in this world. But we're looking at what the Lord would have us to see about this coming up out of the earth with this power to give life unto the image of the beast that he told the world, make an image of the beast. I'm going to give, look, just look at this, what's that? I'm going to give that image life. Oh, can you see the world now? The world is here to, I don't mean to harm, but it's kind of like the golden calf syndrome. You know, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up and make an image to the beast so that he may give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. Well, that's right down the line with Daniel, isn't it? You're not going to worship the beast, you know. You're not going to worship the image, you know. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Well, if you don't worship this bat, anytime you hear the dulcimer and the trumpets and all of these things, you don't bow down to worship the image, you're going to be thrown into the lion's den, or you're going to be killed, or thrown into the fiery furnace. And I just want to say this as well, too. that the three Hebrew boys who were later released from the fiery furnace sang a song. They were in the furnace singing because we know that the angel Elion has the power over the fire. So they were in the fiery furnace singing praises to the Lord, and they could not understand on the outside what was taking place. But it's like the children of Israel going through the Red Sea. God said, "You shall pass through the waters, and the flood shall not overflow thee." He also said, "You shall pass through the fire and shall not be burned." So there are words that identify everything that is going to take place. And we see here, as it was in the days of Daniel, you don't worship the image, oh, he's going to throw you in that fire, you know, but you have to have God within you. And here we are again coming around with the same kind of event during these days and times. The image is here. You're going to make the image speak. I don't know if you, perhaps you may use ventriloquism. We don't know how you may make that image speak, whether it's by ventriloquism or by cloning or like some of the old priests in the old days used to do. They used to put someone under the altar and they would dupe the people in thinking that the statues were actually speaking. And we can see all of these things taking place in this time. And you know, your life is going to depend on an image that someone makes speak. Now that just don't make any kind of godly sense. But that's the condition. And I hope you see the condition that the world is going off into at this point and time, and understand the state of the world at this point in time. Verse 16 says, "He causeth all, both small, great, rich, and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead." Now, he caused these things to take place. Now, if he calls these things to take place, it means that you don't have the power to resist him. All right? If he calls these things to take place, but look at what he is doing, and it is all against godliness and righteousness. And that no man, verse 17, might buy or sell, save he that hath the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. Think about that statement. He is trying to identify you either by mark, by name, or by number. Praise the Lord. And I want you to understand quite clearly that we've already been told, come buy without money and without price. We've been told that already. So you're either going to accept what God says at that time in the state of the world, under the state of those world conditions, or you're going to have no choice, and I would not be so gullible and so vulnerable to these kinds of things. We will continue further. God said the same. Be blessed, global Christian friends. We bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.